pandas. Okay, so here we are reading the CSV file, that is 6 PG CSV. So in that we have a text document, that is whether we will have a positive or a negative opinion data. Okay, so that one we are reading, that one we have to, and we are giving the labels. Okay, you know, message and label. We are giving the two columns we have. In the two columns, one that we have a message, another one is a label. Okay, so we are giving the names, and we are storing that one in message variable. Okay, and we are printing the dimension, dimension of that data set. What is the dimension of that data set? So here, that is 18, 2. So in output, see that output I executed already. So 18, 2. It means 18 rows. Okay, so that is 18 rows and 2 columns we have. So this is the data, and we are using. Okay, so 18 rows and 2 columns we have. That is, one is text document, 18 text sentence, that is sentences. Another one is target, that is positive or a negative. Okay, so then we are. And after that, what we are doing for label, okay, so if it is positive, we are making that one as 1, and if it is negative, we are making that one as 0. Okay, so in the text document, we have a positive POS have or negative NEG we have. Wherever a positive comes, we will put 1, and whenever negative comes, we will put 0. Okay, and we are storing that one, we are making storing that one to a message dot message will be in X, and a label will be Y. That is in text document, text will be in X, and target, that is label num, is nothing but a target 0 or 1, that is positive or negative, it will be stored in Y. So, and we are printing X and Y. So here I am printing X and Y. So this is the I love this sandwich, this is an amazing place, this is nothing but a text, that is nothing but a X, that one we are printing. After that, here we are printing a Y. Y is this one positive 1 1 1 1 is there now. So this is column number, leave it. Okay, so 1 1 1. So these are nothing but a target, positive or a negative. So wherever positive comes, we are output will be 1. Wherever negative comes, it will be 0. So total 18 rows are there. Okay, so we are printing. Now here we are splitting the data set into training data and test data. Okay, so for that we will have a inbuilt function, that is a library train test split. So using that we are printing, you know, splitting the data. Okay, so X train X test, Y train Y test, that is X, that a text train and text test, and the target Y train, target Y test. Okay, so we are passing those values, we are print splitting the data, and we are printing the shape, that is what is the size of that test data, train data, test data, train data. So here we are printing, so 513 530. Okay, test is total 18 rows are there. In that rows, for testing we are taking 5. Okay, and here for training we are taking 30. Okay, so that one we are taking here, test and train we are splitting, that is testing will be 5, training will be 13. Okay, so we are splitted a test data and train data. So now we will use, okay, so we will use one function, counter vectorize. So count vectorize, what is that count vectorize? It is used to, you know, convert the text document into a collection of words or a tokens. So here I have a text document is there now. So in that, so using this counter vectorize, so what we are doing, we are converting the text into a words or a tokens, a number of words or a tokens. That one we will do using this counter vectorizer. This is inbuilt API. So using that, we are converting the text document into words. Okay, so we are, that one we are calling, and we are passing that X train, the training values we are passing. Okay, and that one will be, we are fitting into that counter vectorize. Okay, so and if we are we are transferring into a, you know, within a, we are transferring into individual text and text array tokens. Okay, that one we are printing those things, count vectorize get future names. So here this is the, so when I'm printing this one, we will have this number of text documents, you know, that that will, the text document will be converted into a number of words. For that we are using this counter vectorizer. Okay, that one we are printing. Okay, so that is we are printing that one. So if you want to print that one in a data frame, okay, so that is when you convert whatever we want to do something, that one we need to convert it into a data frame. So that one we are doing here, we are converting that one will be array will be converted into a data frame, that one will be stored in df. Okay, that one will be print df is nothing but this is the tabular representation. Okay, so this is the tabular representation of data frame. Wherever it comes we will put one, and wherever it will be zero. Okay, so this, okay, so then after that this is sparse matrix for representation of the, so here wherever that one will be we are displaying here. Okay, so this is the tabular, this one is the tabular representation. Okay, this one is the tabular representation. Okay, after that this is the sparse matrix xtrain.ttm. This is the sparse matrix representation. Okay, this is this is nothing but a sparse matrix representation. Okay, that is true positive, true negative, false positive, false negative. This is the sparse matrix representation. Okay, so now we have, you know, we have converted that one into text into words. So after that we are representing sparse matrix, all those things we have done. So now we will apply this multinomial NB, Navy Base Classifier. This is inbuilt function, Navy Base Classifier. So automatically it will predict the correct outputs. Okay, so it will predict the correct outputs, that is positive values will be corrected, how much it will be predicted based on training the model. Okay, so multinomial DB, this is the inbuilt functions we are using, and we are fitting the model by passing the xtrain values and ytrain values. Okay, so we are fitting the values by passing the xtrain and ytrain values, and after that we are predicting the, we are training the model here. Okay, so we are training the model. After training, using the training model, here we are predict the values by passing the test, x test values. Okay, so here it will predict it. Okay, so that is CLF is nothing but already, the CLF is nothing but already trained model. Okay, that using the trained model we are predicting the values by passing the test, x test values. The text will be text document, text will be the given, and we need to predict, that is whether that one is positive or negative. That one we are doing here. Then after that we are calculating the accuracy. Then after that we are calculating the, okay, so accuracy we are calculating. After that we are putting confusion matrix. Then after that we recall and precision. Okay, so here, so accuracy of the, how will so here for that we will have inbuilt functions, matrices that accuracy score, and here we are putting a y test and predicted values. So this accuracy of the our model will be the 0.8. so these are all inbuilt. Okay, so the accuracy of the classifier will be 0.8, and we have a confusion matrix. Okay, so confusion matrix by passing the y test value and predicted, so we will have a confusion matrix 0.3011. This is the confusion matrix. Then after that we need to calculate the recall and precision. So recall will be calculated, recalls underscore, by passing y test and predicted values, it will be 0.5, and the finally the precision will be the by precision underscore score y test comma predicted. Okay, so it will be the 1. Okay, so like that we need to, you know, all are inbuilt, just we need to use the those libraries, and we need to calculate the accuracy, precision and recall. Okay, so this is the program 6. So here we are converting, you know, we are identifying the predicting the text document will be that sentence will be the positive or negative. Okay, okay, thank you very much. I will end the session now.